Let us take a moment and come together in prayer. On behalf of all the Sisters of Charity of Leavenworth, who have the privilege of sponsoring Cristo Rey, Kansas City, I welcome and thank you for being here tonight. I can already tell there's the gift of community and celebration and fun in the air. So let us take a moment now and remember the promise of Jesus. Where two or more are gathered, the Spirit of Jesus is in our midst. Let us pray. O loving and creator God, we give you thanks this evening in a special way for your gift of life to each of us. We give you thanks for the ministry of the School of Kansas City, Cristo Rey. We are indeed impelled by the love of Christ to give this service to those in need. We give thanks for the wonderful men and women who will share their talents on this dance floor this evening. And we give thanks for all of you supporting this ministry and education. O Creator God in Jesus, bless all of us, the food that we are about to share, the men and women who put it before us, as we celebrate this night in your name, sharing many gifts. Amen. Thank you. Enjoy the evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host for this evening's activities, Maria Antonia.
The look on your face. Can't wait to see your reaction when you see the moves on this stage in just a few minutes. I saw them during rehearsal. Welcome. How wonderful it is to have all of you here supporting the more than 300 students at Cristo Rey, giving them a better chance at a good education, a college education, a career. It means so much. And you're here, you know what it means. We can't thank you enough for your support. This is our seventh year, and you know the number seven in many cultures, it's a lucky number. For example, in China, seven means togetherness. And we're glad we're together with you here. 950 of our closest friends, this is a sellout crowd, probably our largest. Thank you. Thank you. We have some good news to share with you. 2013 will mark the fourth class of graduates at Cristo Rey. Now, and these students want to be the fourth class to have 100% college acceptance. And so far, the seniors have signed, sealed, and delivered 261 applications to 75 universities all over the country. They're getting it done, by the way. For many of them, they will be the first ones to go on to college in their families. So this means a lot to those students, to their parents, to their brothers, their sisters, their families, to everyone. Along with all of you here, we also have to say thank you to some folks who are really, really helping us make a difference for these young kids. These are our Golden Waltz Circle organizations and businesses. We want to thank them, absolutely. Folks like the Gaslight Grill, doing a lot for these kids. Also getting in there and helping out the Archer Foundation. We appreciate it tremendously. Same goes for energy. Awfully glad to have that kind of backing. Thank you so much. The Kelly Family Foundation. Great folks, great to us. And also, we can't go without saying a big, big thank you to MedTrack for the help. Speaking of the moves you're going to see, Ballroom Unlimited, they're the folks that have been working with the stars. They take these folks, they figure out their strengths, their personality, what they can do and what they can do best, and put together a routine and practice. And one of the dancers mentioned earlier during practice, one dance alone could have as many as 2,000 steps. Some folks don't even walk that much in a day. So it's great exercise. Also, T2, once again, has brought its A-game to dancing with the Kansas City Stars. And tonight you will enjoy T2's nationally recognized artistry and expertise in digital media. So Cristo Rey certainly appreciates the help we get from T2 as well. All right. Your table, all of you have wrapped around your napkins the ballots. Let's talk about this because this is what it's all about tonight. Votes are $10. You can vote more than once, though. You can vote as many times as you want. The more you vote, the better the chances the person you're backing here will win. Ballots will be collected at the conclusion of the 8 performances we have tonight by our stars. And you can vote anytime during the evening and then hand your ballots to a table concierge that will be coming around. Also, you should know that online voting for this has been going on since November. The folks that you are here to see and the ones that you are backing, they've had support since then. They've had sponsorships. They've had people who've already started backing them way back then. Keep that in mind as well. Want to introduce to you some longtime best friends, Bonnie Kelly and Teresa Walsh. They earmarked $25 from their grocery budgets to pursue their passion, sterling silver jewelry. Now, when Bonnie's husband Jerry joined them in 1997, the trio made history. They rocketed Salpata Designs into an international gold standard brand. Bonnie and Jerry Kelly are active members of this community and believe that quality education is a human right. Please welcome these fine folks. I'm not used to giving it up that often.
Okay, so what a great event is this. How many of you are ready to do some voting? Now remember, even though you came here to vote for maybe just one specific person, you can vote for other ones too, so you don't want to hurt their feelings, so we can vote for lots of people. But seriously, because of your voting and your continued support, all the graduating class, 100% of the graduating classes have gone and are going to college. Pretty cool. Now, last year, I just happened to be one of the dancers, so I'm really happy. I have to say I'm on this side of it this year. But thanks to Ballroom Unlimited for making me sort of look like I could dance, so that was very fun, as is going to happen with these dancers. But I have to share with you a really quick story. The day of the event, when we were doing the rehearsing, I actually got to hang out with some of the students, and they're darling. And I remember asking, there was a bunch of them, and I remember asking them, how many of you are seniors? And they're like, I am, I am. I'm like, okay, what college are you going to? And every single one had a college or one they were applying to with the most enthusiasm and passion. And I thought, you know what? This is the real deal. And that at that point, I just thought, you know, I'm so blessed to be able to be dancing for this amazing, amazing organization. So tonight's going to be great. I've heard lots of good things, and Jared's going to talk to you about a little something.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to have some fun tonight. We're going to celebrate these great dancers, and we're here to support a great school, Cristo Rey. I'd like to take a brief moment to just chat about a program that I think is foundational to really the success of Cristo Rey, and that's the Corporate Work-Study Program. You may not be familiar with it, but every student who attends Cristo Rey must work one of the 5 days through the week at a business or an organization throughout the metropolitan Kansas City area. And they're paid for this 1 day, and that payment goes directly to their tuition. So each of these students is so engaged in their education that they are literally putting themselves through school. I think that deserves a round of applause. And I know our company, Slapata Designs, has employed 3 of these students each of the last 2 or 3 years, and they have become a great part of our company. They're involved in the marketing department, the sales department, the accounting department. Our people love them, and it really gives these kids a chance to be exposed to a business environment, and they're all, to a person that we've had, they're all engaged, they are all proud of what they do, and they all make significant contributions. I would encourage all of you and your companies that you're affiliated with to learn more about this program and to check out the website, and if you have an interest, give Cristo Rey a call. Let's have fun tonight. Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, let's meet our judges, the folks who will take a look at what goes on stage and how wonderful it is. And some of these folks have done it themselves, so you sit here judging with some idea now of what goes into getting all that dancing done. Ed Holland.
Mr. Ed.
Mr. Ed. All right.
The horse.
Ed, an alumni dancer yourself. What was it, last year? Or the year before, a couple of years ago. Yeah. Chairman and president of Myron Green and its flagship EBT restaurant. Winner of a number of awards. A lot more fun, I would guess, to judge than it is to go through that.
Oh, yes. I'm so glad to be here and not over there and then there. Life is good to be a judge.
Yes, yes, we appreciate it. Glad to have you. We'll be talking through the night as we take a look at what these folks are able to do. Unbelievable. Hello, I'm going to have to stay on this side or come behind you because I don't want to step in front of you folks and then everybody can't see you. Heather Bortnick, president of the Kohler Bortnick Group, a company you founded with your mom.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Together you ranked as the number one real estate team in Kansas City for 18 years. Heather is pleased to be back at Dancing with the Kansas City Stars as a judge. In last year's competition, you were one of the fierce competitors.
Well, I don't know about fierce competitors, but I did compete, and it was really fun. I thoroughly enjoyed it. So, and I feel for all of these lovely men and women over here because it's much more difficult than you think it's going
to
be.
It is difficult, and it's great to do once and say I did it and then be done with it too sometimes because it is tough. It is a tough thing to do. And we have, of course, with us also the Honorable Sly James, Mayor of Kansas City. A native of Kansas City who proudly claims diplomas from Bishop Hogan High School and Rockhurst University in his academic portfolio.
Yes, indeed.
Makes it sound fancy schmancy, doesn't it?
It does, it does.
Now, your experience as an attorney will serve you well on the bench tonight as a judge for Dancing with the Kansas City Stars. Mayor, 2 years you've judged.
Yes, and I think we probably ought to not use the experience as the attorney. I was much more partisan then. I think that it's good that I'm here because you really don't want to see me out there.
Well, see, that's exactly what I think is the question on the minds of the folks here. Judge twice. What about actually getting out there?
Yes, yes, yes.
Just say.
Thank you very much. Won't happen.
Let me think about it. No. Glad to have you anyway. There you go. They're already stepping up.
I can't even be bribed with beautiful women.
All right, then. We tried. We really did try. All right. Folks, let me just say this. This is going to be, and I've used this word intentionally, wild from the very beginning. So we're ready to see our first couple, our first dancers. Please welcome them, and let's get to know them a little bit.
My name is Phil Smith. I am a partner and vice president, general manager of Dick Smith Ford in Raytown, Missouri. I think the closest to how I dance is probably like Elaine on Seinfeld. And actually, she's not all that bad. If you looked up Angel in the dictionary, it would have a picture of Mary. Even though my dancing is atrocious, she always tells me how wonderful I am. Everybody kept saying, oh, no, no, no. You'll be, by the time you have your like 83 lessons and everything else, you'll be wonderful. They were lying. Yeah, I'm glad I don't cry easy.
Dancing the East Coast Swing, Phil Swingman Smith and his partner, Mary Pinizzotto.
About that. Quick question for everybody here. Raise your hand if you know Phil. If you've, yeah? I know Phil as a very, very dedicated volunteer at Bishop Sullivan Center. And, thank you, and I have to say that I never, ever will look at you the same way, Phil. How did this happen? How did you pick this? How did you pick this routine? Is this a part of your personality we didn't know about?
Yes. Yeah. You have to pay to see it, though.
We're not even going there. Easy to get him to get the routine down? It sounds like you guys, it looks like you guys had a blast.
We had an amazing time, and Phil is really a huge inspiration to me. The kind of amazing work that he does in his life. And I have to say, doing this routine, he was really an animal.
Do we want to elaborate or do we want to keep this clean? Can I borrow this thing when you're done with okay.
Mick Jagger.
Yeah, Mick Jagger wants the pants back. Sure. All right. Stand by. Let's see what the judges think of this fun performance tonight, Ed.
Phil. Leopard leotards on a car dealer. Amy, his daughter's over here coming out later. Amy, what'd you think of this guy? No, seriously, Phil, I thought you did a beautiful job. There was a lot of entertaining value, a lot of excitement. You missed one little step right here, but that was okay. That was okay. So I'm going to give you, because I love car dealers, a 10.
Heather?
I just couldn't get over the pants. You came out, and I'm like, oh, my gosh, this is awesome. And the fact your daughter's dancing, I don't know who to give the higher score to. I'm wondering if, oh, you? Okay, yeah. That's not an age-related thing or anything, is it? Anyway, I thought you did fabulous, and your routine was so fun. That was awesome. And your partner is so fun. Yeah, you got a winner there. So I thought it was wonderful. However, don't shoot me. I'm giving you a 9.
Mayor.
Well, I got to say, there were a couple of things that I was struck by. First of all, looking at you from this angle and with your arms up, I thought, well, maybe an armpit trim would be appropriate. But but then I understood the jungle theme, and I thought, well, what the heck, you know? I hope this isn't going to be showing up in any commercials soon, but, you know, I'm amazed a man of your age is so athletic. I think that you'll feel it tomorrow, but I think that I think you did a miraculously great job of moving. The acrobatics were great. Because you're number one, though, I will do a 9. I think that we simply have to wait, but I judge hard. Outstanding.
Thank you. And Phil's daughter is, in fact, one of the dancers coming up in our second group. And all day we've been watching them, and they say they've been able to get along. There's no fighting over this. They're both just as competitive. So we'll see. We'll just see how that works out. A reminder right now of the reason why we're here. We're going to take a look at a video here that will take us back to that and then go on with the dancing.
Cristo Rey, as we all know, is a very different high school, and different in a good way. It wasn't what I expected, but it was more than what I bargained for. Like, I could have never imagined getting all the tools that I got at Cristo Rey. Like, it was a blessing in disguise, really.
I'm Connie Fahey. I am a nurse case manager. I predominantly care for seniors in our community, and I'm their patient advocate. Gil is a lot of fun. We were matched perfectly because I'm all about having a good time. I laugh a lot. I'm not very serious, but he's very professional. He probably grits his teeth several times working with me a night. I danced with my dad when I was a kid. He used to roll the carpet up and we would dance to Lawrence Welk. It didn't really prepare me for this.
Well, I was dancing with my baby.
Connie, the dancing diva, baby, and her partner, Gil Maldonado.
Streets of Soho in the rain. He was looking for the place called Lee Ho Fooks. Gonna get a big dish of beef chow mein. Ah, where was it, London? Ah, where was it, London?
calling on the kitchen door. You better not let him hear. Little old lady got busy late, late last night. Well, won't land down again. Ah-hoo, werewolf of London. Ah-hoo. Ah-hoo.
Well, I saw Lon Chaney walking with the Queen, doing the werewolves of London. I saw Lon Chaney Jr. walking with the Queen, doing the werewolves of London. I saw a werewolf drinking a pina colada at Trader Vic's. And his hair was perfect. Werewolves of London. Proper.
I got a tail for you.
My tail didn't fall off.
Interesting choice, and it didn't happen by chance.
No, actually it happened. She walked in on her first lesson, gave me two options. Bruce Springsteen, Working on the Highway, or Warren Zevon, Werewolf in London. And then she starts spitting out the picture of doing the werewolf thing, and we could do this and claw each other.
And he was really worried he was gonna have to be the werewolf, but not so much.
As much fun as it looks to get it done?
You know, it's really hard to dance. And if any of you think this is easy, come on and do it.
It could mean 1, 2 to 3 hours a week of practicing, and that doesn't count, you know, warming up or...
Try five hours a week.
And you know, you have to stay in shape before you get out there because you don't want to, you know, hurt something. So it's a lot of work. It really is.
Lots Wonderful. Of fun.
Absolutely. All right, let's see what the folks back here think. Ed, how about that?
Connie Fahey, you lost your tail. The little malfunction here on the wardrobe here.
Yeah, huh? I know. You just keep going.
Okay. Connie, I thought really this was a beautiful, beautiful rendition of a wonderful dance. Wardrobe. Pretty exciting. You were a little short on your lines, your hand lines. But, yeah, a little stretch it out a little bit. But Kevin Fahey, do you know Kevin? He used to kick my ass on the football field. So he doesn't hit me again. I'm going to give you a 10, Connie. So you were beautiful.
All right.
It looks really good.
Heather? I loved the sideburns and the whole ensemble, and it is so difficult just to dance in front of your friends and peers and coworkers and whatnot, but then to dress up like you did, I mean, I was like, wow, you have a lot of self-confidence. I was like, this is awesome. However, that being said, I was really looking for more hip motions when you, I'm like, where is it? You got this whole costume. I know, but I can't give that to you because you lost your tail after you started the hip motions, and then, I don't know. So I thought you did great, though. I love the hand motions, everything. It was fabulous, so 9.
You're welcome.
Mayor, this must be the only place where you'd want to see a werewolf in Kansas City.
I do have to tell you that I hope that you remember to do something with the hair before you go out tonight.
No, she's keeping it on.
You could scare a lot of people. Very nicely done. I agree with you. Nothing easy about anything that you're doing up here. People ought to recognize that. I think you did a very good job. I'm beginning to wonder if we have some sort of a weird animal thing building here or what. But, you know, you might want to stay away from the other guy. You know, werewolves, leopards, whatever, they don't get along. I thought you did a very good job. I am going to give you an 8, however.
All right. This may be the wildest part of our program tonight. We're gonna, you know, shake it up a bit, do a few different things. They do have a fan club, don't they? And before we go on to our next couple, I want you again to hear from the students that we are here to support.
When I went to Cristo Rey, we had a seminar class that taught us how to make resumes, apply for scholarships, apply for schools. Cristo Rey pushed me and gave me the confidence to believe that I could go to college and also experience at the workplace.
My name is Alejandro Lopez. I'm interior designer at Alejandro Home Design. When it's professional level, everything changed. And this is not like go to a party or to a club that you just dance. This is serious. Yeah. This is a responsibility for everybody to do this. We're talking about prepare these kids for the future. All the ways that we can give back to our community is the most important thing that we can do.
Dancing the salsa, Alejandro Senior Salsa Lopez and his partner, Abby Vogels.
Shake your body, baby, do the conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do the conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
Fabulous, absolutely fabulous. Now, I'm not making any predictions by bringing up the past, but a few years ago, another performer did the salsa wearing a hot pink garb just like this, and I don't know if it was a fluke or not, but that performer won. Yeah. Does anybody remember that? Yeah.
Who was that?
Me.
Oh.
It's a fun dance. It's fun. Why'd you pick this one?
It is. I love salsa, and I'm from Spain, and always connected to the Latin music. So, and my fabulous.
He asked specifically for a Latin dance. So, a lot of people were doing cha-cha, and we decided to do something different and go with salsa. I think it worked out nice. What do you think?
Yeah.
And you picked Gloria Estefan music to get it done?
Estefan from Miami. Yeah.
Actually from Cuba.
Cuba. Yeah.
Living in Miami now, but that's okay. It's all good. All right. Absolutely delightful. Let's see what the judges have to say about this. Ed, how about that?
Alejandra.
Where'd you get your partner, buddy? Man. You're from Spain, right?
Yes, I am.
Oh, I like Spain. Alejandra, you have this beautiful woman, but you almost dropped her right here in the middle. What was that?
That's part of the show.
Oh, it is? Okay. And there were a couple of missteps, but, you know, the flow was nice. I loved the excitement. It was really a beautiful dance, but dropping your partner, I'm going to have to give you an 8. I'm sorry. There you go. I would never drop a beautiful woman like that.
Heather. Okay, I'm giving you an extra point than I normally would have because you have a really sexy accent. That's fabulous. I mean, really? I mean, on the video, you had me on the video. I'm like, I don't even care if you can dance. I'm like, oh my gosh. So, but anyway, I also am impressed because you had like a kind of slight to major stumble there where you almost dropped her, but you regained your composure, which is not always easy to do. So, very impressed. However, I do have to agree with my fellow judge, an 8.
Mayor, have you ever done the salsa?
I eat salsa. but I think I have the vapors. That was hot. I like my salsa hot. It's the only way to eat it. Outstanding. I thought you, young lady, are exquisite. Alejandro. I won't say you're exquisite. I think that would be the wrong adjective. but you held up your end of the bargain pretty well, except for that one time. A little bit of a misbeat right at the beginning. You were half beat slow, I think, perhaps. Yeah, just call them like I see them. But it was, I thought, an interesting, energetic dance. You're to be commended on not doing something that has to do with animals. I've got to give you an 8.
Thank you very much, Mayor. I should tell you, if you like it hot, stay tuned. There's more like that on the way. Yep, indeed. And we have one final couple in this part of the competition coming up. But again, because we all know why we are here and the important part of this evening, let's take another look and hear from another student.
My family consists of my mom, my dad, and my 9 siblings. And we're just one big family. My favorite thing about Cristo Rey was the family. Aspect of it. Everybody was family. The teachers cared, the students cared about each other. And since it was a small school, you can really get a good relationships with people here and feel safe and feel that this is a safe place to go and learn.
Jane Guard. I'm going to be doing the cha-cha tonight. I wanted to do a fast dance because I was worried that I might be boring, so I wanted to do something fast and exciting. Well, Perry Gingrich is my partner, and he owns Ballroom Unlimited, which is a fabulous training ground for all of us. It's been really fun to see all the dancers show up. We kind of bump into each other, and you know, when you look at other people's dances, you think, oh, they're really good. I'm not gonna be as good as they are, but in reality, we're all doing this for Cristo Rey, and that's our goal, and we're a team.
Dancing the Cha-Cha, Jane Miss Cha-Cha Guard, and her partner, Perry Gingrich.